Okay, so this notes page is on solving systems of equations, but it's just the graphical method. Okay, so first of all, what is a system? A system is the word we use when we're looking at two or more equations that are bound together. And when a solution exists, the system is said to be consistent. Otherwise, it is said to be inconsistent. Okay, so a linear system in two variables can be graphed as two lines. So let's break down what that means. So if we have one line, y equals negative x plus 4, and we have another line, y equals x, and we look at them together, that is called a system. Okay, and I about had this one, let's just change that to a 3. So these are actually the equations of these two lines. And a line is made up of ordered pairs. Okay, so this line has an ordered pair of 0, 3, or negative 1, 4, or this line has 1.5, 1.5. These are all ordered pairs on this line. This line, y equals x, has ordered pairs negative 2, negative 2, or negative 1, negative 1, or 1.5, 1.5. There's only one point that works for both of these lines. There's an infinite amount of ordered pairs on this line, there's an infinite amount of ordered pairs on this line, but there's only one point that is a solution to both of those equations individually. So that means that's the solution to that system. Okay, and that's all you have to know right now. Now I'm adding this so you can kind of anchor what's going on. What this means is that if I were to let x be 1.5 and y be 1.5, see how it works in this equation here? 1.5 does equal 1.5. And if I were to let 1.5 be x and 1.5 be y, look and see how it works here? Negative 1.5 plus 3 is 1.5, and that's the only point in the world that is true, going to make both of those true statements. So that's the solution to the system. It's just the intersection. All right, if the lines are parallel, let's say I have two parallel lines, we know that parallel lines never intersect. So if I ask you to solve this system, when you see parallel lines, you would say, well, there is no solution, there is no intersection, there is no one point that is on both of those. And that's called an inconsistent system. Number 5, if you graph the lines and they're the same. So if you look at this, it's hard to see what's going on here, but there's a line there. It looks like one line. This comes from Desmos. I typed in y equals x, and I typed in 2y equals 2x. So they're really the same line because this is just this line multiplied by 2 on both sides. But sometimes that happens. Okay, so if you do that, the lines are the same, then they're called consistent because at least they have solutions, but they're also called dependent. Because like here, there was only one point that made both of those true. Okay, this line has an infinitely many points that are going to satisfy both of these. So you would say that the system, the solution is there's infinitely many. The system is consistent to many, consistent dependent, but there's infinitely many solutions. And we'll leave it at that. So we'll say the solution is, and then the system is called a consistent and dependent system. Okay, so this final example, we'll just use Desmos. Okay, so it says use Desmos to graph the systems of equations and then find the solutions. So just type in the first one, x plus y equals 3, and 2x equals y, and the solution is the intersection. It's the order pair 1, 2, and remember that saying that x is 1 and y is 2. 3, it checks out. If I put 1 here for x, 2 times 1 is 2, and it does equal y, which is 2. So this is the only point that works for both of those. So that's the solution to the system. So if we try another one, the second one, x minus y equals 4, and 2x plus y equals 2. There is the intersection. 2, negative 2 is my solution to the system. If I put in 3x plus y equals 2 and 2y equals 4 minus 6x, look at what happens there. That's the same line. So the answer to this one would be infinitely many solutions, because there's an infinite amount of ordered pairs on that line. All right, number 7, we can have nonlinear systems. So a nonlinear system is still the same thing. It's two equations, and you're looking for the ordered pairs that intersect. In this case, it's a quadratic or a parabola intersecting with a line, and there are two ordered pairs that make both of those true. So 0, 0 and 2, 4 are both solutions. So number 8, we just have some examples here. These are nonlinear systems. We have a circle and a line, and they are intersecting in two different places, once here and one here. So both of these ordered pairs are solutions. So you just pull it off the graph. This is my origin. This is negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the ordered pair negative 3, negative 4. And over here we have 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 3, 4 and negative 3, negative 4 are the solutions here. You could have a circle intersecting a parabola, and their intersections, there's two of them, here and here. And then you read it off the graph. This is negative 4, 3, and this is 4, 3. So those are the two solutions there. C, you have a parabola intersecting another parabola, and they are intersecting here and here. So those two solutions to the system would be negative 4, 0 and 4, 0. This one, you have a sideways parabola intersecting a line. Looks like they are intersecting in two places, here and here. This point is over 2, down 2, so 2, negative 2. And this point here, 1 is 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 4. So that's all there is to solving systems graphically. You just look at the graph and you find the places where the two equations intersect.